My name is Clemens Neudecke. I'm gonna give you a very, very brief introduction, and then my colleague Kai will continue with the juicy technical details. So we're based at the library, but we like to consider ourselves researchers, so we participate in this. This is just the overview of our talk, and it will mainly center around the linking and disambiguation part, since we developed our recognition system already previously. So yeah, our contribution is based in the context of a larger scale AI ML project that we're participating here in the library, and which aims to develop like a full pipeline for going from documents to enriched semantic content and for the curation of that content, and across a couple of domains. There's a lot of also industry partners, and you can see different domains here, culture, media, etc. And our contribution is in the curation of digitized cultural heritage. Just a quick note that we're gonna run our second conference, 10 to 11 February 2021 in Berlin, as an online conference, and we just published a call for papers. So if you're interested in the topics of digital curation, please feel free to have a look at the call for papers. And just to conclude this short intro, also all of our data and our code is published open source, and you can find it via these links. And with that, I hand over to my colleague Kai.
Okay. Hello. I'm giving you some details about our named entity recognition and linking system. First, I want to talk briefly about named entity recognition. It's very brief because there is already a publication available about it, and we concentrated on linking in this competition. So just to give you an overview, the NAR system we used is a BERT-based NAR tagger. This NAR tagger has been pre-trained on the MathLM and next sentence prediction tasks on historical text material of the digitized collections of the Berlin State Library. We used in the competition our off-the-shelf system and did not train on the hype training data. Our off-the-shelf system does not support prod and time entities. We used two different models. For German, we used a model that has been trained simultaneously on historical and contemporary German named entity ground truths. For French and English, we used a multi-language model that has been trained on German, French, Dutch, and English ground truths simultaneously. Okay, after having identified the named entities, we want to link and disambiguate them. And in order to do that, we need something like a knowledge base. And we created three different knowledge bases for all the languages. And basically, we did that by recursive traversal of the category structure of the German Wikipedia. And for all three supported entity types, we basically took some or several categories and all their subcategories and all the Wikipedia pages that are part of those categories belong to the knowledge base. In order to derive a French and English knowledge base, we first mapped the identified German Wikipedia pages to Wikidata IDs, and then we mapped those Wikidata IDs back to French and English Wikipedia pages. Okay, some statistics about the knowledge bases. So the German knowledge base is significantly larger than the English and French. And the coverage of the test data That means how many of the Wikidata we found in our knowledge base and after the test data had been published. As you can see, the coverage is similar for German and French, around 70%, whereas it is significantly worse for English, just around 50%. Okay, our named entity disambiguation and linking works basically in three steps. The first step is the so-called entity candidate lookup. And this works as follows. Let's say we have some sentence where some part has been tagged as, let's say, a person entity. We have some knowledge base where all the persons are part of that knowledge base. And what we do is we map the text part and the entries of the knowledge base to some vector space. And in that vector space, we perform an approximate nearest neighbor search. The vector space is defined by certain BERT embeddings that are stored in an approximate nearest neighbor index. We perform a lookup of up to 400 candidates with a hard cutoff distance of less than 0.1. The approximate nearest neighbor index uses 100 random projection search trees, and it also uses an angular distance measure. Okay, after we have determined a set of candidates, we evaluate each candidate. This is the second step, the so-called candidate evaluation. And in order to do that, for each candidate, we consider up to 50 sentence pairs A, B, where sentence A is a part of the text that is subject to named entity linking, and sentence B is a part of Wikipedia and contains an explicit link to the particular candidate. We then have a purpose-trained BERT model which determines the probability that the sentences A, B refer to the same item. If we do this for all the 50 sentence pairs, we obtain a set of matching probabilities per candidate. This set of matching probabilities then is fed into the ranking step in order to determine the final outcome. The last step is a candidate ranking that works on the sets of matching probabilities per candidate. In order to obtain the final ranking, we first compute certain statistical features of the sets of matching probabilities, that is standard stuff like mean, median, min, max, standard deviation, and various quantiles, but also ranking statistic over all the candidates. We have a random forest model that estimates the overall matching probability per candidate on the basis of those features. The final output is a sorted list of candidates that have matching probability above 0.2. It is important to note that we did not implement the nil entity, but we rather either give a sorted list of candidates or an empty list as final results. Just brief overview about the named entity recognition results. This table shows the results of our system SBB in comparison to the best performing system L3i. What you can see is basically that strict NER performance is significantly worse than fuzzy NER. This difference is much more pronounced in our system, which probably is related to the fact that we, on the one hand, did not train on Clif Hype training data, and on the other hand, the different NER ground truth sets we trained on have a rather diverse set of annotation standards. And what you also can see is that the German and French performance is significantly better than the English performance. This is, in our opinion, probably related to the fact that in our observations, the overall OCR quality of French and German is rather similar, whereas the OCR quality of the English text is worse. just a brief discussion of the entity linking results. This table shows the entity linking results where the NAR ground truth has been performed, has been provided to the entity linking system. The table is sorted according to precision. What you can see is that our system performed rather competitive in terms of precision, but has a very poor recall. And you can see that German and French performance is similar, whereas English performance is significantly worse. This is due to the fact that the coverage of the test data of our knowledge bases is similar for French and German, but as I explained in the beginning, it is significantly worse for English. Let me come to the conclusion. What we learned is that OCR performance is very crucial, since everything afterwards is based on it. It is therefore very reasonable to invest into a proper text error cleanup. We learned that better NER for noisy historical text material is possible due to the results of the best performing team L3i. We think that the recall performance of our entity linking system has the biggest potential for easy improvement, for example, by deriving the knowledge base using Wikidata. And we think that our NEL precision results look promising and are a good starting point in order to further develop our system. Okay, that's it. Thank you for listening and please ask.